एवरीवन, माय शॉर्ट निर्दोष एज यू नो एंड इट इज अ लेक्चर ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ द रूट्स पार्ट 3. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सॉल्व ऑल द डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ द रूट. सो दिस इज द थर्ड प्रॉब्लम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रीड द प्रॉब्लम. सो गिवन दैट द इक्वेशन 2x² माइनस 2cx प्लस ab इक्वल टू 0 हैज रियल एंड unequal roots, real and unequal roots. Then find the nature of the roots of the equation x square minus 2 times a plus bx plus a square plus b square plus c square equal to 0 where a comma b comma c belonging to real number. Fine. Then solution. Given that this equation means 2x square minus 2cx plus ab equal to 0 has roots are real and unequal. Means a discriminant of this equation is greater than and equal to 0. Because of that this equation has roots are real and unequal. So the discriminant of this equation is greater than 0 means b square minus 4 times ac is greater than 0 for this equation. If we put the value of abc of this equation for this equation, then we get b square means minus 2c whole square minus 4 times a means 2 and c means ab is greater than 0. So from here we get 4c square minus 8 times ab is greater than 0. Let it is the first equation. Fine. So from this equation has the roots real and unequal. So from this equation we get 4c square minus 8 ab is greater than 0. And on the further solving we get c square minus 2 ab is greater than 0. Fine. Okay, and we have to find out the nature of the roots of this equation. So for finding out the nature of the roots of any equation, first of all we have to find out the sign of the discriminant. So write the discriminant for this equation. So d equal to b square minus 4ac for this equation, and we get d equal to, put the value of b equal to minus times 2 minus 2 times a plus b, then minus 2 a plus b whole square minus 4 times a means 1 and c means a square plus b square plus c square, a square plus b square plus c square. On the further solving we get d equal to 4 times a square plus 4 times b square and plus ka 8 times ab. Fine. And from here we get minus 4 times a square minus 4 times b square minus 4 times c square. Okay, so it is the plus 4 square, it is a minus 4 square, then these two terms are cancelled out, it is a plus ka 4 square, it is a minus 4 times b square, then these two terms are cancelled out. Then we get d equal to 8ab minus 4c square. Fine. If we take 4 as a common, then we get ab minus 2c square. Fine. Okay. From here, we know that c square minus 2ab is greater than 0. Okay. Fine. If we take minus common from this term, then we get 2c square minus ab. Fine. And 2c square, from here we get 2ab minus c square, 2a, c square minus 2ab. So we get c square minus 2ab is greater than 0. So means this term is greater than 0. So here minus sign is here. So finally we get d is less than 0. Okay, because of that c square minus 2ab is greater than 0, if we multiply by the minus of this term, then we get d is less than 0. So in the so we get b is less than 0 for this equation. So we can say that this equation has imaginary roots. So equation has imaginary roots. Because of that, d is less than 0 for this equation. So this equation has the roots real and unequal, means d is greater than 0 for this equation. So if d is greater than 0, then we find out, then b gets c square minus 2ab greater than 0. And we have to find out the nature of the roots of this equation. So find out the value of the discriminant of this equation. So we get b square minus 4ac. On the further solving, we get minus 4 times c square minus 2ab. And from here, we know that c square minus 2ab is greater than 0. Means this term is greater than 0. If we multiply by minus in this term, then we get d is less than 0. So if d is less than 0 for this equation, then we can say that roots of this equation are imaginary. So this is the final answer of this question. Thank you. So it is a fourth problem. So read this problem. Given that, find the set of the value of a, set of the value of a such that the equation has imaginary roots and equation is x square plus a square equal to 8x plus 6a. So given that this equation has imaginary roots, this equation has imaginary roots, then find the value of a. A means this a. Okay. Solution. So given that this equation has imaginary roots, means discriminant of this equation is less than 0. Fine. So we can say that the discriminant of this equation is less than 0. Okay. So we know that discriminant of this equation is less than 0. So we know that discriminant d equal to b square minus 4 times ac. Okay, fine. So from here we can write b square minus 4 times ac is less than 0. Okay. So put the value of a, b, c from this equation. Okay. So if we solve this equation, then we get x square plus a square and minus 8x minus 6a equal to 0. Okay. Then x square minus 8 times x plus a square minus 6a equal to 0. Okay. So from this equation we get b equal to b. What is b? B is the coefficient of x. So from here b equal to minus 8. So if we put the value b equal to minus 8, then we get minus 8 whole square minus 4 times. What is the value of a? Is the coefficient of x square. Then what is the coefficient of x square here? Equal to 1. Then 1. And what is the value of c? C is the constant of this equation. Then we get a square minus 6a. Fine. Is less than 0. And after that we get 64 minus 4 times a square plus 24 times a is less than 0. Okay. If we multiply by the minus of this equation, then we get 4a square minus 24a minus 64 is greater than 0. If we do the multiplication by the minus, then sign of the inequality is also changes. So it is less than 0, then become greater than 0. 4a square minus 24a minus 64 greater than 0. So if we solve further of this inequality, then we get 4a square minus 24a minus 64 is greater than 0. If we take 4 as a common from this inequality, then we get a square minus 6a minus 16 is greater than 0. Okay, then we get a square minus 6a minus 16 is greater than 0. If we solve this inequality, then we get a square minus 8a plus 2a minus 16 is greater than 0. Okay. If we take a common from these two terms and then take 2 as a common from these two terms, then we get a from a minus 8 plus 2, then we get a minus 8 is greater than 0. If we take common a minus 8 from these two terms, then we get a minus 8 and a plus 2 is greater than 0. Fine. So if we solve this inequality, then we get a equal to minus 2 and a equal to 8. Okay. So here should be plus this. It is the method to solve the inequality. So it is the plus minus plus. Starting from plus minus plus. Take the alternative plus minus plus minus plus. And why a equal to minus 2? Because of that, if we take a plus 2 equal to 0, then we get a equal to minus 2. And if we take a minus 8 equal to 0, then we get a equal to 8. So just from this inequality, we required greater than 0. So means we require the positive value. So or take the positive sign. Take the positive, negative sign. Starting from always from the positive and take the alternatively positive and negative, positive, negative. Similarly in this way. So from here it is the minus infinity, and if we go up to the right hand side, then we get plus infinity. Okay, so just we require the positive, so we can say that a is belonging to minus infinity to minus 2 and union from a to infinity. Okay, fine. If we put the value of a from a in this range minus 8 minus infinity to minus 2 and from a to infinity in this equation, then this equation has the roots are imaginary. Fine. So these are the interval of the value of a in which this equation contains the imaginary roots. So this is the final answer of our question. Fine. Thank you to watching this video. Okay, so come to the next lecture, and in the next lecture we will discuss the several concept based on the quadratic equation. Fine. If you have any query, then please or comment on my channel. I will try to solve your any query and any problem. Thank you.